Chapter 2. Then I lifted up my eyes and looked, and behold, there was a man with the measuring line in his hand. So I said, "Where are you going?" And he said to me, "To measure Jerusalem, to see how wide it is and how long it is." And behold, the angel who was speaking with me was going out, and another angel was coming out to meet him, and said to him, "Run, speak to that young man, saying, Jerusalem will be inhabited without walls because of the multitude of men and cattle within it. For I, declares the Lord, will be a wall of fire around her, and I will be the glory in her midst." Pause. So these angelic messengers were compelled with excitement to announce that Jerusalem will become so large that it will extend beyond all walls. This has not been fulfilled, so is clearly pointing to a future time. The fire around the city implies divine protection. This will be the time of the Messiah's rule on the earth. "Ho there! Flee from the land of the north, declares the Lord, for I have dispersed you as the four winds of the heavens, declares the Lord." Pause. Babylon was the land of the north, and the message for God's people was to flee from her. Verse 7. "Ho Zion! Escape you who are living with the daughter of Babylon. For thus says the Lord of hosts, after glory he has sent me against the nations which plunder you. For he who touches you touches the apple of his eye. For behold, I will wave my hand over them so that they will be plunder for their slaves. Then you will know that the Lord of hosts has sent me." "Sing for joy and be glad, O daughter of Zion, for behold, I am coming and I will dwell in your midst, declares the Lord. Many nations will join themselves to the Lord in that day and will become my people. Then I will dwell in your midst, and you will know that the Lord of hosts has sent me to you. The Lord will possess Judah as his portion in the Holy Land and will again choose Jerusalem. Be silent, all flesh, before the Lord, for he is aroused from his holy habitation." Okay. So all of God's people should be excited that he will bring many into his kingdom. God's desire to bless Israel was never intended to stop with Israel, but to use them as a channel of blessing for many nations. Today's saintly snippet is from Integrative Theology by Lewis and Demarest. The prophets and apostles warned of judgment and called people to repent of their unfaithfulness to God and others. At the same time, they also called people to believe the news of the Messiah's coming atonement and resurrection, and to trust Christ himself. In societies that are far from just, whether communist, socialist, or capitalist, the message of a just amnesty created a forgiving community. Christians are not merely forgiven, they are forgiving. The unjust today cannot succeed in suppressing their guilt nor in denying the reality of their sinfulness. Psychologically and spiritually, spouses, parents, children, employers, and employees need to see the dynamic of Calvary's forgiveness that satisfies justice and graciously provides new life from above. All right, let's pray. Heavenly Father, we appreciate that you've chosen the weak things of this world to confuse the haughty and the mighty. Thank you that we who have nothing to offer can be used by you. We ask that you would continue conforming us into humble, submissive, trusting, available people who can be used to do your work in this world. Please multiply our joy, Lord, and use us mightily in the days ahead. Help us to have a spirit of wisdom and revelation in knowledge of you, a spirit that gives us comprehension to the fullest measure in this life. Allow us to know the deep things about you, and knowing them, to use them for the sake of your kingdom and your glory. We thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you, guys. Hope to see you tomorrow, Lord willing. All right. Have a great and wonderful day. Take care.